Okay, so first thing, let's quickly go see how our tables look. So if we look at our score table, so we want to remove one of these. So we're going to need to know what player it is, and we're going to need to know which hole. So we're going to need to ask him the player ID and the hole number so that we can delete that particular line. We can't just ask for the player ID, otherwise it will delete all of these scores. We can't just ask for the hole number, because then, like, there is hole number 1, but then if you go down, there is another hole number 1 for player 2. So we have to go ask for a particular player ID with that player's hole number, then we can delete that row. So we need two pieces of information to know which one to delete. Alright, so let's go. So now in our remove, step 1 would be we need to ask for, we want to know the hole number and we want to know the player ID. So we need to know the hole and the player ID. Both is integers, so let's stick with integers for now. Alright, so we just want to ask the user. Obviously, if any of you want to ask questions or make the statement, please just send it through. Or just ask me. Alright, so step 1, get the hole number. So a hole, and then we want to do it with input box, but remember, input box always gives us a string. So we need to just change our string to int of input box. I don't know how I can change this stuff. Input box. And input box has got 3 pieces. Alright, so step 1 is this will be the delete button. Example hole number 1, and our player ID is also an integer, but we're also going to get it as a string, so string to int input box. Alright, this is also the delete button, and this is which player ID. Let's use player ID 2 just because, as an example. So we're going to ask the user which hole does he want to delete, and then we're going to ask him, okay, which player ID does he want to delete. Now, do you agree? Same with our change button. We need to find out the stuff. Now we have to start at the first one while we're not at the end, and we need to go to the next one. So we have to do the same things. But the only difference is with our holes. The holes is our table 3. Alright, so we need to start with our ADO table 3. We want to start at the first one. Then we want to carry on while we not for our ADO table 3 at the end of the file. We want to do begin, and then you have to remember just before the end, put your ADO table 3 dot next. Always do these 3 steps together. Your while loop has got 3 pieces. It's always your condition. Before the while loop, you need to initialize your condition, and inside the while loop, you need to change your condition. So we want to, while we're not at the end of our table, so that means beforehand, we must just start the table at the first one, and then on the inside, we need to just go on to the next record in the table. So that will take us through the whole table. But now what we want to do is we want to go look for this hole and that player ID. So now with this, we can just do it with the if. So if the hole we're looking for is equal to our ADO table 3's field, which is called, let's just see that we also call it whole number. Let's quickly see here the scores. Player ID and whole number, yeah. So the field must be whole number. Whole number. So if the whole is equal to the whole number, and our PID is equal to our ADO table 3's player ID. See, if the whole is equal to that whole number, and the PID is equal to this player ID, then the only thing we want to do then is, in our ADO table 3, we want to delete that record. And that's literally all you do. The only thing with this also, okay, with this one we didn't need to do that. Okay, let's see if this works. Let's quickly play. So let's see the scores. Okay, let's go remove a score. I want to remove player 1. So which hole? I'm going to say hole 2 of player ID 1. I want to remove this one. This 1, 2, 2. Let's see, okay. Okay, player ID not found. Okay, let's quickly break this. Okay, let's go see. What is that field called? Score. Player ID whole number. And score. Oh, table 3 is whole. Aye, aye, aye. ADO table 2 is our score table. So, that's why it said it can't find player ID, because in table 3, the whole table, there's only a whole number and par. We wanted to work with ADO table 2 here. So this should have been our ADO table 2, do the first one. While we not have ADO table 2 at the end, ADO table 2 dot next. If our whole is equal to ADO table 2's whole number, and our player ID is equal to ADO table 2's player ID, then our ADO table 2 dot delete. Okay, let's try this again. Score, so let's remove a score. Whole number 2 of player ID 1. Okay, let's go see. Okay, number 2 is gone. Whole 2 is gone.